manipulation technique. No. It is not, I'm doing this just so you can do this. Some of the reasons that, you know, things don't work out, he says that.
Tell him how much you appreciate him getting out there looking for that job and that group that I'm making.
A Greek or a Jew. But God sees us all as one.
The very fiber of your being. She speaks to your inner man.
Yes, indeed. She, you know what, I...
You know what I share with others, just this idea of going through.
I'm in the car now. During that time,
to submit my plans for you in the long run.
Yes.
And so sometimes God, not only is God getting glory,
but you know, we can definitely put him in a Hawaiian shirt without your pants. Oh, girl. Now,
did you see the color just go out of her face? And it has to be a beautiful dress, right?
Yes.
Okay. Discussions about life and love and the way things ought to be. I am Minister Igola, your host. That's the morning after show, ladies. That's M-O-U-R-N-I-N-G, not M-O-R-N-I-N-G. And we have a wonderful show planned for you tonight. You know, I said that the show, that our discussions are dedicated to life, love, and the way things ought to be. Tonight we're talking about love. Yes,
love,
ladies. Yes,
air.
It is. Yes.
Is
and we all love love. Ladies love to be in love. We love literally loving people. But you know, one of our favorite things, and you guys correct me if I'm wrong, we love weddings.
Yes.
Ladies,
yes,
love
weddings.
The weddings. Yes, indeed.
Ooh, I've never been who I want to be. I never felt completely free. No one's ever had all of me. I made me feel so beautiful and sexy. Now I'm flying like an airplane. Now I'm riding on the open range. Now I'm living out my destiny. I know the truth, I got it all in you and me. Giving
whole production of the moment. But I'll throw just a little bit of information out there to you as soon as I get an introduction, because some of our audience members may not know my co-host. So go ahead and reintroduce yourself to the audience members, because we're always picking up new venues, new avenues where we're showing the show. So I want them to know who you are. So go ahead, please.
Hello, I'm Natalie, and I am one of the co-hosts for The Morning After.
And I'm Jean Sattler. I'm one of the co-hosts, and I'm enjoying myself.
Hello, I'm Mary Hubbard. I'm one of the co-hosts here at The Morning Show.
Yay. Morning after. They know what you're talking about. Ladies, let me give you some startling statistics. And we've talked about it on the show before. We've spoken in depth about the fact that when we look at African-American women and we look at the rate in which they're getting married, that literally the statistics are dismal. They say that only about 30% of African-American women are getting married, right? Well, I was looking at that and I found out the statistics were a little bit skewed, you know, as data is oftentimes. Those statistics were relating to women who were between the ages of 18 and 35. Okay.
I'm not even sure why 18-year-olds even put
come
in
on
the statistics.
In the statistics at all. That didn't even make any sense. Mm-hmm. But what the statistics showed was that after 55, about 90% of African American women have been married. So that seems a little bit more acceptable to us, right. But I was thinking about this, Wyatt, and maybe I'm wrong, and maybe I needed to do a little research, but I was thinking about, why is it that African-American women are not getting married? Is it what they're saying, we're just too mean, and, just don't know how to act, and all of that, and, you know, we can't be that bad, and I hate to put it like this, there's no shortage of African-American babies, okay? Marriages, okay? So there has to be something appealing. But anyway, ladies, I'm thinking that it may have to do with the fact that weddings are so expensive. That's absolutely crazy in the price. We were talking about it, Natalie and I on the phone as we were planning it. And she says, okay, I want to get married. This was so funny to me. I want to get married. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to set aside $100 a month. Was it 100 or two?
$200
a month. And I know I need to get to $10,000. And she start doing the calculations. Wait a minute. It's going to be like 8 years.
Yeah,
before she could even get married. So there must be a better way. And so tonight our show is about planning a wedding on a budget. Now, ladies, we have $2,500 only to plan this wedding. Because if we look at it, Natalie then can get married within a year, and that's what she wants, okay? $2,500 is all we get to spend. And we've got to decide in this show exactly what we need for this wedding, what we want for this wedding, what's going to make it special for us, because we don't want it to just be thrown together. It has to be special. So I want to hear your ideas. I first and foremost want to come up with a list of exactly what we need for the wedding, okay? Once we decide what we need for the wedding, then we need to decide what we can do without, what we can live without, and what we must have in order to make this wedding work. And then we've got to find resources on the internet or on the telephone, people that you know, that literally can do it. We've got to decide a budget. How are we going to divide this budget up? How much money are we going to spend for what in order to make this marriage work? But we know that not marriage work, but the wedding work. Now, we know we got to decide on things like the color, the venue. We've got to decide on the menu. We've got to have to decide if you're getting distressed.
Okay, so $2,500. So grandma's backyard with Aunt Mary making the potato salad.
If necessary, but is that going to satisfy a bride? Okay.
Depending on how bad she want to be married.
Yeah. Okay, so, you know, maybe what we need is we need an actual bride. Since you are wanting to get married, will you be our bride tonight?
Sure, I'll be your bride.
Okay, so as we're proposing things, it has to be, Natalie has to give the okay. But Natalie, I'm telling you, you only have $2,500.
I know.
And we're not, okay?
That's for her dresses.
That's for everything. Yeah. Everything. Oh. We are not coming out of our pocket to give you any more money in order to get married. And I need to let you know that. And we need your married girl, okay? Because we need everything to be legit. Right, we want her legit. We want you to be able to walk with your head up high, and say, "I's married now. I's married." We want that to work for you.
Yes.
Okay, so everything has to go through Natalie. She only have $2,500, and yes, ma'am, that does include the dress as well. Okay. Okay, so who's going to, Miss Jean, since you have a pad in front of you, would you please take notes for us of the things that we definitely need for a wedding?
Exactly.
Okay, so let's go ahead and do that. Ladies, what will we need in order to make this wedding work?
A beautiful dress.
We need the beautiful dress. Okay, and it has to be a beautiful dress, right?
Yes, of course.
Okay.
For a beautiful woman.
Not necessarily a gown, but a dress.
Okay, Okay, she said that you may not be able to get a gown. Okay, but that's okay.
But you can rent one.
Are you okay with that?
You can rent one.
I mean, you really are okay with that.
I have to be. But my sister sold, so can't she make my dress?
Okay, well, maybe that's an option we can use. Mm-hmm. But we've got to decide how much it's going to cost for your sister to make the wedding dress. Because I happen to know that sometimes when you make it, it costs more than if you bought it.
It just depends. It just depends.
Then I also know that there are sites out there that sell wedding dresses for cheap.
Yes. Yeah,
so okay, and you may want to look on that site and see if you can find something for cheap. Okay? Okay, what else do we need for this wedding?
Flowers.
We need flowers.
Yes, you need flowers.
Do you have to have flowers for the wedding? Well, let's just make the list first.
Okay,
so flowers. What else?
Food.
You gotta have food. You gotta feed the folk. Mm-hmm. Okay, who come to your wedding.
And we need a venue.
We need a venue. The venue is where we're gonna have the wedding. Okay?
Yes.
So?
Wedding and reception, if we can have it at the same place.
Okay, at the same place. You think so? But
whatever's cheaper.
Location as well. So venues, put an S, because we need two and we may be able to use the same venue. Okay? All right? Okay. So what else, ladies, do we need?
Drinks.
So we're going to include that with the food. So food and drinks. Oh,
now,
you're talking about drinks.
Does $25 include the groom and expenses?
Yes, indeed it does.
Wow.
Yes. Wow. This is $2,500. That's all we get.
So we take care of the groom.
Wait, groom take care of, he takes care of himself.
We have $2,500.
Your family takes care of you.
$2,500.
It's part of the budget.
Okay. All right.
So where are we going to put that?
So are they going tux or just regular?
Well, we're going to have to decide that.
Ooh,
okay.
This dress is
outfit for a groom.
Outfit.
Outfit for a groom.
Because, you know, we could definitely put him in a Hawaiian shirt, a pair of short pants, and just go, girl. Come on. No, okay. Don't. Did you see the color just go out of her face? Who
she could rent a tux?
Bridesmaid.
He could rent a tux.
And
we need bridesmaid dresses, don't we?
They buy their own dresses.
Well, I mean, but we still need to put them on the list.
Yeah.
But that'll be a solution that we can use.
Okay, yeah.
Okay?
I don't know any.
We need flower girls.
Okay.
We have the groom. We have to take care of the groom.
Okay, the groom's outfit.
Ring bearer.
Ring bearers.
One.
Well, when we say the venue, y'all know, and the food, you know we've got to have something to serve the food on.
Right.
Yes.
So you do need the plates and the decorations.
Would include that.
And that's including, like, the table settings and everything?
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? So what else?
We need a minister.
We need a minister. Mm-hmm. Ministers cost money. They do. Okay.
Does this include the wedding license?
Yes, it does. Please put the license on there.
You still have to do the blood test?
You do not have to do the blood test anymore. So definitely you can marry your cousin. If you want to, I mean, it's up to you. It truly is up to you. Okay?
Yeah.
Yeah. Limo.
The limo?
You know,
transportation. Put it on there.
Yeah, transportation.
Okay? We may not be able to use a limo.
No, $2,500.
Okay, so we're going to take pictures?
Yes.
Okay, so we need pictures. Because you got to remember the occasion. We need a videographer and a photographer.
Mm-hmm.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so
we need a DJ, maybe?
Yes, we do need a DJ.
DJ? Got to have one.
Because I like to dance.
Okay, so she got a dress. Does she have shoes on, or is that all one thing?
I think that might be
shoes. She got to have shoes. Let's just finish decorating the bride. So as long as she has on a dress and shoes, does she need anything else? Oh, we need
her
rings.
Accessories.
Accessories. We need rings.
Earrings.
Your bridesmaid's gift.
Yes, which would probably be their jewelry.
Do we need a wedding director or a wedding planner?
$2,500.
Yes,
need
one.
You need one, but
okay. Alrighty. Hairstylist.
Mm-hmm. Hairstylist. Makeup artist.
Makeup artist. So you gotta have one.
Nails.
Where this budget is getting stretched thin, ladies.
Maybe
you're already
overdrawn. I'm already overdrawn. So we have to overdraw the bank account. Maybe take out a loan. No taking out loans, because you don't want to start the marriage off in debt.
Can we call a lifeline? Get some money.
Cannot. You've already used all your lifelines. The $2,500 you got was from other people. And no, ma'am, we're not gonna give you $500 extra for this wedding.
If we have a garage sale, we might can make a $500 extra. We gotta combine the household. We might
okay,
a
all right.
Sale
so
too.
I'm gonna tell you what. Here's what we're gonna do. If you want to do something of that nature, then you put that in the corner that we could have a garage sale. But I want to talk about that garage sale, because okay. I need for it to be legit, because I need for you to go to your house and tell me what it is you're willing to part with. Okay? Mm-hmm. So we're going to do that. All right. So let's go on. Stemware.
Is that included?
It should be included with the food.
Okay. How about thank you cards?
Right. I was going to say invitations.
Invitations. Thank you cards. And set the date.
Remind them. We haven't gotten a wedding cake yet.
Oh, right.
Gotta have a
wedding cake. Wedding cake. Mm-hmm.
Not at the end of the show, I might not want to get married.
Good afternoon. Well, you have caught me off guard with this message. I didn't come prepared. But nevertheless, it has been a long day, long weekend, but it has been worth it to get to this point, to see everything come together, and I definitely do appreciate all the efforts of everybody, and definitely do appreciate you. And I look forward to spending this night with you and, of course, the rest of my life. So for me, Dale Scott, I say I love you and look forward to this day. Bye.
Now that the moon is bright.
Dearly beloved, we are gathered together here in the sight of God and in the face of this company to join together this man and this woman in holy matrimony, which is commended by St. Paul to be honorable among all men, and therefore is not to be entered into unadvisedly or lightly, but reverently, discreetly, advisedly, and in the fear of God. Into this holy estate, these two persons come now to be joined.
Seriously.
Okay. All right, ladies. So, is this all that we need?
We're talking two cakes.
You're talking to a bride and the groom's cake.
So, also with the wedding, I don't know if decorations would include the carpet you roll out and the chandeliers.
Mm-mm. Well,
because you can't be
the lights, candles.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Candles.
So let's do this right now. Let's go back to the very, very top and let's look at each one of these items separately, okay? Because we got to decide, does it include the decoration, the place setting decorations and things of that nature? So let's start at the top with a dress, okay? Now with a dress, are we going to have this dress made, or are we going to buy this dress?
Do we want to look and see if it's cheaper
to rent one? Yeah.
Oh, to rent? Okay, so that's what we're going to do right now, ladies. We have $2,500.
Yes.
Okay. How much do we want to spend on the dress?
Well, I want the bride to be happy. So,
how much you want to spend?
Yeah, I'm going to let you all choose the price, because you all have been married before. I've never been married. So,
what kind of dress? Do you want a spaghetti strap off the shoulders?
No, I want off the shoulder. I want it to be.
You want it fitting or wide? You want vintage? You want lace?
I want it I want it to fit here and then widen out. So sort of a princess style dress.
You want it down to the floor?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so she wants a gown.
Okay, so we're going to say that we'll give her $500 for the dress? Or is that too much? That's one-fifth of the budget.
I think we can find a dress for cheaper than $500.
I think $500.
What do you think?
We want her to be pretty. This is her special day.
Okay, mm-hmm. So $500.
$500.
Okay, $500 it is for this, okay? What's next on the
flowers.
Flowers. Do we need flowers, ladies?
Yes.
We need the only flowers we have to have is for the bridesmaids. Flower girls.
You mean for
the
bouquets?
Yeah, the bouquets.
So we're not going to go in this place, wherever we are, there will be no flowers within this place. There are going to be no flowers on the table. There are going to be no flowers within the chapel, none whatsoever.
You're going to have one centerpiece.
Wait a minute. Is this a sit-down dinner? Wedding?
We're going
to decide. Is it $2,500?
Or it's just at the church and you
okay,
have
so we're not going to have a sit-down. We're not going to have a sit-down at all. How are we going to feed the people?
Oh, no.
Finger food. Are you going to do finger food?
We're going to have to do finger.
Pimento cheese
so sandwiches.
So
maybe what we need to do is we need to find the venue first.
Yeah, let's try the venue first.
Okay, so let's do this. Let's stop and do the dress and the venue. So you guys work on, who's going to work on the venue?
I'll work on the venue.
You're on the venue. And then who's going to work on the dress?
We'll work on the dress.
You'll work on the dress and we'll work on the venue, okay?
Well, let's find out. Natalie, you want to be local?
Yes.
Okay.
So it has to be local. We got to find a venue. You guys are finding a dress. Make sure you talk it out so that we do not lose our audience. What are you finding? What are you seeing? And things of that nature, okay? Mm-hmm. So, Mary, I'm going to come around. Well, no, I'm not going to come around to where you are.
I just want to ask Natalie one other question.
Yes, ma'am.
Maybe the venue could be a church. How do you feel about that?
I don't think my mama wants me to have church wedding because I had a child out of wedlock.
Okay, that's another show, right?
Oh, Mary, that was great. I love that. Most definitely, that is another show. However,
hotel reception rooms are options. Like hotel meeting rooms.
I think in today's society and acceptance, you're okay.
Can we say this? Can
Do
we
you
say
go to
this?
Church?
That yeah, you go to church.
Yes,
she goes to Union Grove often.
Yeah, you
so,
go to church.
Okay, can we
there.
Say this? That even though your mom may not think that's the best thing for you, that we would go with a church because a church will be a lot cheaper than trying to do a hotel reception room.
Right. Okay,
okay.
Yeah, we'll
because
we'll
I know to
church.
Rent Union Grove, I think it's like $300. Or something of that nature, if you're not a member. So if we make you a member, not a member just for the wedding, you know what I'm saying? That kind of deal, if you are a member, I think it's cheaper.
Let's just say she is a member.
She is a member.
She is a member.
Okay. So is it okay if we choose your venue as a church?
Yeah, that's fine.
Okay, is it okay if we choose Union Grove as your church?
Yeah, that's fine.
Okay. So what we need to do now is we need to figure out how much it costs to actually rent Union Grove as they are doing the finding the dress right now, okay? And you guys, you may want to go and you go ahead and make the phone call and see who you can call to find out how much it costs in order to rent Union Grove. You may be able to find it on the website.
Oh, okay.
But ladies, are you putting in cheap dress or do you just put in wedding dress?
You found a dress so cheap. Tell me, look how much that is.
$182.
Okay, but look at the size because that's the trick with the cheap dresses. They only come in certain sizes.
Well, she will fit that certain size. Right, Natalie? You got a year to lose some weight if you don't.
So now we're going to make the girl lose some weight.
Mm-hmm. Okay, that's what my daughter is doing so she could get the cheap dress.
Okay,
according to this, I'm good.
You're good?
Size, yeah.
Okay, so
where
100.
Is that?
AdoringDress.com.
Would you please write down AdoringDress.com and it's how much?
$182.
How much is the shipping and handling? And how soon before you get it back? Okay, Mary, have you found anybody
not
to ask
yet.
As of yet?
No, you have to order it 6 months in advance.
6 months in advance? Okay, let me see who I can find as well for that venue to ask and see who we can find in order to... Okay, I think I got the person.
Okay. Free shipping to orders over $129.
Okay.
Girl, we did it.
We did it.
Bam.
Yep.
Y'all got it?
Free shipping.
Okay.
Now, what's your daughter gonna do? Is she gonna be a maid of honor?
She's gonna be a bridesmaid.
Bridesmaid. Mm-hmm. Find her dress.
You're looking on the website right now, Mary?
No, I can't find it.
Okay. Okay, so mine just dropped through. Let me see. Let me keep asking people. Okay. And while we're doing this, we're going to go ahead and we're going to take a break. And when we come back, we're going to see whether or not we were able to find a venue price. We found the dress, and we're going to go from there. Okay? All right, so we'll be back in about 5. And welcome back to The Morning After. We are planning a wedding. It is time for Natalie to get married, maybe, maybe not. We don't know, but we're planning a pretend wedding. And we're trying to do it on a $2,500 budget. And before we left, we were trying to find the dress. And ladies, did we find the dress?
Yes, we found the dress.
We found the dress.
Very beautiful dress. The dress
and you would actually wear this dress?
This is the dress I want, actually.
Are you serious? Mm-hmm. And it cost how much?
$182.39.
Okay. Wow, that's so cool.
And if you ship it, the shipping is free if you spend over $129, which we did.
Okay, so the dress is done. Mm-hmm. Okay, so then with the venue, Mary, we decided what regarding the venue, or did you have something to say about the dress?
I want to know where did you find the dress?
AdoringDress.com.
Okay, so ladies, you hear this, AdoringDress.com. She found her dress for $189. $189 for a dress. Now, I've seen Save the Dress. I mean,
Yes to the dress.
I've seen that, and I know these people are paying $3,000-$5,000 for a wedding dress. Right. But is that really necessary? No. And I know that you want to pass your wedding dress on down to your child, but maybe you're just going to have to help the child buy a dress.
Well, being that I'm 4'11 and my daughter is 5'6, that won't be happening.
Exactly. So
182 is fine.
Is fine with you. Okay.
But she found the bridesmaid's dress.
You found the bridesmaid's dress.
$82.09.
How many bridesmaids are you going to have?
Four.
So that's 80.
Well, we have to decide if
I'm not going to buy the bridesmaids' dresses, but we just found them at a nice price since we're having a cheaper
wedding. Who are your bridesmaids in like real life or whatever?
In real life, my bridesmaids are my daughter, my best friend Talisha, my niece Michelle, and then the other one will be one of my fiance's cousins, but I'm not sure which one.
There you go. Why don't you get them on the phone right now and say that if I was asking you to buy a bridesmaid dress for $82, would you actually be willing to buy that wedding dress? Because some people are going to say no.
All of them will say yes.
Okay, I need proof, please. Proof positive.
I don't know anybody's number by heart, but my daughter, she's at work.
Okay.
I think most people would do it.
For $82, less than $100. Anything
okay,
over
now if we plan this wedding and they don't buy their dresses and they have to come in their pajamas, it's going to be on you, ladies, because I tried to get you to verify.
$82. I think most women, if they can't afford it, they'll tell you.
Right.
And you'll find someone else.
Yeah.
But most women will go ahead because shame.
It was $200. The wedding I was just in November, it was $200 for the dress and the shoes.
Okay.
So this is way less than the dress was $150.
Okay, so I suggest you go ahead and try to find the shoes while we talk about this venue.
Okay.
This venue. So
back to Natalie, do you agree on the church?
Yeah, the church is fine.
Is it okay for the reception to be at the church?
No.
And come on now.
No, because she want a DJ.
Yeah.
Okay, so we're going to have to find another venue for the reception. Okay, we do have the church, and the church is going to cost us $350 because she is a non-member. So if you'll go ahead and write that down for us, please. And we're already at almost $500 right there, but we still have a budget of $2,000 remaining.
Okay.
Ladies, we're going to make this beautiful. Now we've got to find a place for the reception. Do you have any places in mind?
I heard of this golf course in Tyrone, Georgia, called Window Coffee Golf Course. They have an event center.
And there are a lot of event centers out there.
It's
so
really reasonable.
Now, event centers, I know there's one here in Noonan as well. So why don't we go ahead and try to find this event center? Okay, you'll do that, Mary. And I think that I'm going to talk to you, Natalie, about as you're looking for that. Okay. You're looking for the shoes?
Yes, I'm looking for shoes.
Okay. Are you going to have premarital counseling?
Yes, ma'am.
You are? You know that's going to cost money, right?
Yes, ma'am. But this also in this this very small budget that...
Yes, it's also in the small budget. So what I'm about to do is, do you have a minister in mind?
Look, are you giving a discount? If so, yes, you.
Well, then you just lucked up because I'll do it for free.
Hallelujah.
Okay? So you can put zero for the premarital counseling, and you're going to want me to perform the ceremony, and you got your own pastor
my
for that.
Sister's.
Your sister? Now, is your sister going to charge you for that? No? Okay, zero for the minister.
Look,
we
what
got
you talking,
it.
What you talking about, Willis?
All right, so the sister's going to perform the wedding. I'm going to do the premarital counseling. Now, wait. Can I do premarital counseling? I've never done it before. I want to know why. Because I'm not married. So
we just need the godly aspect of
it. So if you'll take the premarital counseling from a person who's not married, okay. How about you, Mary? Did you find a place for the reception?
I did. Let's call this number.
Okay. Let's call the number and see.
770.
ABK, babe. 770.
969.
969.
44.
69. 69. And what is it called?
Wendell Coffee Event Center.
Okay.
It's very beautiful.
Wendell Coffee Event Center. Now, what city is this in?
It's in Tyrone.
Tyrone, Georgia. Okay. So we'll see if we get somebody on the line and see how much this is going to cost us in order to do it. Okay, ladies, talk to us about what you're doing. Come on out.
We are not having much luck with shoes. At least I'm not. I'm not sure how her look is going, but...
Why don't you just look at Payless?
Yeah, I guess we could.
I'm so sorry, Mary. You are out of luck. They're not open. So you need to find a place where the price is actually listed on
the... If the price is not listed, for the most part, it's usually out of your range if you're planning an affordable wedding.
Okay. Really? Is there any place that we can think of where you automatically know that it's going to be cheap because of the type of facility it is?
Like a Masonic Lodge.
Exactly. Exactly. Mm-hmm. Does anyone here at the table belong to the Masons?
Or of Eastern Stars?
Not at all. Mm-hmm. So here's what we're going to do. We need to find a place for the reception. We need to find some shoes. So we're going to take a break, and we're going to come right back. Mm-hmm. And yeah, maybe we'll have some luck over the break, okay? And welcome back to The Morning After. We're in the middle of planning a wedding. And when we left and we went off the air, we were actually looking for the venue for the reception. We were also looking for shoes. Did you find anything regarding shoes? Anything that was acceptable?
Sorry, everybody.
Bless you.
I actually found a little heel at JCPenney's for $39.99 for me.
Okay, $39.99 it is. Mm-hmm. Okay. All right. Did we find a venue for the reception as of yet?
Not yet. I'm still working on it.
Okay. So you find that for us, and we're going to move on. We said that if we find the venue for the reception, we now have to decide on things like the stemware, things of that nature. Ladies, stemware.
I was told to go to SmartyHadAParty.com for...
SmartyHadAParty.com
for plates.
Can you pull that up and let's see what SmartyHadAParty.com. Does that sound like some place that you want to buy your wedding and stuff? But we're not being picky, are we?
We could do the cheap wedding reception food and drink menu ideas on a budget.
Okay, well, tell us about that.
Too, while I'm checking here. Okay, yeah, this actually is pretty nice stuff.
Okay, what is that? Tell us about it.
This is SmartyHadAParty.com. And they have on sale now let's see, look, they have plates, glasses, tablecloths,
so they have everything that you need.
Everything
now
that
do
you
they
need.
Have package deals that you can use?
Don't know if they have packages, but it's pretty reasonable because my niece said for her wedding she got 120 plates for $99.
120 plates for $99. Okay, go ahead, please.
So,
are we going to invite 129 people to this wedding?
120 people.
120.
No more.
We're going to have 120 people at a wedding that's $250, $2,500?
I said no more. We're not going to have any more than that. You're saying that's too many. Is that
no? I'm asking you. Are we going?
What's your guest list? How many is on your
I
guest list?
I have 8 brothers and sisters, 17 nieces and nephews, and 6 great nieces and nephews, and that's just my immediate family.
So how many is on your guest list?
We're gonna have to stop at 120 because we could only spend $100 on plates.
120 people.
I like Natalie. She's like, this is it. You know.
Yeah.
She's working with us.
Okay. Yes. So 120. Can you, Miss Jean, can you put down $99 for plates, please? Is that going to include, we get everything, the napkins, the cups, and all that stuff with that $99?
No. Mm-hmm. But we can get white napkins from Sam's.
Really? That's okay with you?
I got to work with what I got. My budget, I can't plan a champagne wedding on a beer budget.
Okay, then. So white napkins from Sam and his.
Budget.
You said, oh, Ripple, this ain't even beer.
Did you say Ripple? Oh, my goodness.
I don't know if I know what Ripple is, but it must be pretty cheap.
Wow. Now, that's that Fred Sanford drink, isn't it? Finding the Ripple. Oh, wow.
You can actually get those little short plastic cups from Sam's as well. You know, the little short ones that you put the drinks in.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
Let me check and see how much those are.
Okay, so you're going to pull that up?
So we're 99 for plates.
For the plates. Mm-hmm. And then you were looking at that menu. Was that menu, did that look like something we wanted to do?
Finger food.
Is it okay if we do finger food?
We got to do what we got to do.
So she's easy. Natalie's easy.
This is just for the show. Trust me, I am.
So you're gonna turn into Bridezilla?
I'm not gonna turn into Bridezilla, but I am the baby, and yeah, Kevin knows how I am.
Wow.
And he still loves me.
Wow.
So your main thing is just getting married, but you want to be nice. I'm just still surprised that you're just saying okay to a lot of these things that would be important to me.
Yeah, because would that be okay for you? Because you got married on $2,500.
I did.
When, in what year?
I'm not going to tell you, but it's been a long time ago.
Yeah, well, no, I'm not saying it like that. I'm not trying to call out old guys. I'm saying that you have to think. And I'm not, I'm going to say the nicest as possible. Would that be considered $2,500 now?
I don't think so.
Now it would be considered probably what, like five?
Probably. Would have doubled.
Mm-hmm. The way you was describing it, I was thinking it was five then.
Oh, you were?
Yeah, at the museum and all of that.
Yeah, I did rent a venue.
You did what now?
I had a wedding at a museum in the city of Albany, the Albany Museum. And being that I was a student, they allowed me to have it there. I think it was just
that was pretty cool.
$183 for 6 hours. And what I did also was we had the wedding. It was a nice day. So once we had the wedding, we asked everyone to go outside for a minute, and then we set up for the reception. We were able to dance and eat there as well. My sisters-in-law, they make the food. We didn't have enough food. If I could change one thing, I would increase the amount of food I had. Had a friend take the pictures, friend play the music, and
so this can be done.
It can be done.
It
also
is
had
possible.
A friend make the dress. That was the most expensive part for me, and it was a gown. It's like she was a dynamic seamstress. We got the sewing the magazine, the wedding magazine. She asked me to look through the magazine. I was really amazed. She said, "Look in this magazine, tell me what do you want? Do you want the shoulders to look like this? You want the bodice to look like that?" And she put that dress together.
And you were satisfied as an end result?
I was totally satisfied. I was amazed. She had the little
beading
body, everything.
Bodice.
Mm-hmm. She did, we got some cheap shoes from Payless.
Mm-hmm.
She dipped them in tea to make them that my color I wanted because I had an ivory. It was really a very nice wedding. I did the flowers myself. I went to Walmart, got the flowers, did the little bouquets.
And now you got Hobby Lobby.
Yeah, that's what I was just thinking in my head. Now you have Hobby Lobby.
So I crafted up my own
40% coupon
for the bride. I did my own bouquet as well as the bouquet for my bridesmaids.
Okay.
So it can be done.
It can be done. And you were satisfied with the end result.
I was.
Okay.
Because she got the mail.
And now you have Pinterest, and you didn't have Pinterest back then.
Right. Tell us about Pinterest.
Pinterest is sort of like a what is it? Instagram. Mm-hmm. But it's you're tagging things that you like. So it's anything from hairstyles to shoes, mm-hmm, to clothes to recipes to anything. So you can look up centerpieces on Pinterest. It'll tell you how to make them. You can look up flowers on Pinterest. It tells you how to make them. You can buy all of your materials from Hobby Lobby. Hobby Lobby has a 40% coupon that you can print as often as you want to.
Right.
So you can go in and get me something with your 40% and I can get the money. I can go in and get something. You can go in and get something. And we all only spent 60% of what the cost was. And you can buy sale items as well with this 40% off.
Okay.
I, Dale Scott.
Take thee, Victoria Coleman.
Take thee, Victoria Coleman.
To my wedded wife.
To my wedded wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better.
For better.
For worse.
For worse.
For richer.
For richer.
For poor.
For poor.
In sickness.
In sickness.
And in health.
And in health.
To love.
To love.
And to cherish.
And to cherish.
Till death.
Till death.
Do us part.
Do us part.
According.
According.
To God's holy ordinance.
To God's holy ordinance.
And thereto.
And thereto.
I plight thee.
I plight thee.
My troth.
My troth.
Love that'll wash over my skin till it's all I feel. So won't you show me that woman who knows me, the woman
loose hands, and Victoria, if you would take his right hand. That's cool.
Okay. For me.
Ladies and gentlemen, I now present to you Mr. and Mrs. Dale Scott. Amen.
You went to Sam's. Did you find anything at
Sam's?
Yes,
I found 240 cups for $10.
Okay, you put that down for us, please. 240 cups for
$10. And I might buy those for real for my wedding while y'all playing.
Oh, wow. Okay. We are helping her out here. And we hope we're helping our audience members out to help you understand that it doesn't have to be an expensive event. Not at all. It is definitely something that you can do on a budget. You're just going to have to put in the time. You're going to have to put in the research. Now, we're going to suggest that you spend more than 2 hours getting your wedding together.
Please,
you know.
This is stressful.
It is stressful.
Yes,
it is.
I'm looking like, oh my God, can I do this?
I'm having a very hard time finding venues
for the reception.
I found this one place in Jonesboro, Georgia. They have this, it's popping up an advertisement saying $3.99, but it won't go any further. I don't know what that involves. It says wedding specials $399. I don't know what it means.
Did you type in?
It's a special event center.
So we're gonna assume that it's event.
They're advertising wedding specials. And of course, I clicked on it, and then
we
have to make an appointment to find out more what it means.
For time's sake, let's just say that it's a venue. Okay.
Okay.
So we got our venue now for $399.
Well, if we can have that place, then we may not have to use the church because we can just have everything there.
Okay, so then we'll save $350 on the church.
Right.
Oh, good.
So if you would scratch that off.
And I have something
you okay
else
not
I need
getting
to renege
married? You really are okay not getting married in the church?
Yeah, I know. I mean, realistically, I already know that's not an option for my family. Okay, so
that's that other show again. Go ahead, please.
Okay, so I found 100 clear plates at Sam's for $11.68. So I could get two packs of those for $24. And now I don't have to spend $100 on plates.
Mm-hmm. Okay, would you start looking at the flowers, please? Since you said that you can put them together, mm-hmm. can you kind of get us a little price on putting together some bouquets? Mm-hmm. Are we going to have her put them together, or do we have to come from the floor?
Yeah,
I'm going to
have you for real, Gary.
Okay.
Yeah,
do you really make flowers? Is that like your gift or whatever?
I'm crafting.
Okay, yeah, so she's going to make you flowers, girl. Linda
from church.
Linda Lambert?
Lambert, yes.
Really, she does bouquets
yes,
or what have you?
Beautiful flowers.
And okay. I have a friend that does, too.
Well, then,
so
can you just, is she
her.
Like a friend of yours, Linda?
Yes.
Can you ask her how much it will cost to make a bouquet? Just
yes.
for a friend?
Yes.
Okay.
I don't have her number right now.
Okay.
I'll try to Facebook her.
Okay. And see if we can get a response. And then in the interim, you can actually look up flowers and see if you can make it yourself. Okay. And what is it that you're working on, Jean?
I'm going to ask my friend how much is a bouquet.
The bouquet as well, mm-hmm. okay? Now, you're actually working on what now?
I'm still looking at, like, plates, because that was just, like, the dinner plate. You still got to have the little cake plates.
Okay.
To put cake on. Right?
Okay. All right.
Well, I think if we're on a budget, well, why don't we just get...
napkins?
Why don't we just get the dinner plates?
Just the dinner plates if you got a good deal.
And... well, yeah, I did just get the dinner plates. And I also, since I don't have to spend as much on the plates as I thought initially, then I want napkins with their name and date. And
okay.
I mean, does that make sense?
Yeah. Beautiful. I think so.
Your monogram napkins, since I don't have to spend as much on the plates.
You
now.
Want monogram napkins?
Right. Because I was going to have to spend $99, but now I only have to spend $24.
Okay.
So I should be able to get monogram
napkins.
I've
always
have
thought
you
about
them?
Oh, no. I was just telling you I was going to do that before.
Okay.
You know.
All right. Go ahead.
I know it's your special day, and I have this thing about monogram napkins. I mean, people just wipe them and throw them in the trash. Maybe we just get a few, just for you.
Yeah.
Maybe for just
the
wedding
party.
Party. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
And
is that how I look them up? Monogram napkins. Wedding.
Also, mm-hmm. what's the? We didn't add. I guess wedding gifts or gifts you give. What is it called?
Well, I said
gifts?
I was going to give my
yeah, we did.
For the bridesmaids
gift.
We're going to, the
sometimes
jewelry
when you attend
with.
A wedding, they always make sure you have a keepsake.
Yeah, some kind of
little
trinket or something.
Trinket.
Even like the little bubbles that you blow. And,
right.
You know,
yeah.
people do all kinds of little
trinkets
or whatever.
So
bubbles.
We probably go to party. What is it?
Party City.
Yeah.
I've gone to a wedding where someone's wrapped some Hershey Kisses in a little cloth.
Yeah,
and that was something.
We'd probably go to Party City and get bubbles, and then print out the little labels and stick them on.
And that's only going to cost about $120,
right?
Well, no, let's double that because we got to pay for the labels. So maybe we're going to say $150.
Yeah, you can print the labels yourself, probably.
Okay, with like your name on it and Kevin's
name
and everything
and the date.
Okay, it looks like we're about to get married.
Okay.
We have at least a preacher. We have a venue. We have a reception place. Mm-hmm. We have the napkins and the plates and all of that. We have the dress. We have the shoes. We have the bridesmaids' dresses paid for. We have the bouquets, at least
mm-hmm.
an idea of where the bouquets are coming from. Okay, what else is a must-have from that list?
What's a must-have?
Your wedding license. How much are the, about 20, I think $35.
$35 for the wedding license. We almost got money left over so you can have a honeymoon, girl.
Ring bearer pillow.
Oh, okay, I looked it up.
Okay, all right.
Let me see.
You can get monogram napkins for only $34.
How many?
Oh, I'm about to see, girl. I got excited. I'm liking this. I feel a little less stressed.
Yeah. Okay, so we got the, by the way, is anybody looking up a cake for me, or can anybody make wedding cakes? Anybody? Somebody?
I'm very picky.
Well, I can, I'm very crafty.
You can make a wedding cake.
I can actually make a wedding cake.
How much will you charge her to make a wedding cake?
Look how Jean's looking at me. I said it may not be the prettiest, and I'm, well, I could put a white icing on it, it'll be pretty.
Okay, so listen, I just found 3 sets, which would be 150 napkins, for $20 each, so that would be $60.
Okay, for the napkins.
150 napkins monogram. Do we? Oh, you said don't get as many. But
Natalie, Mary wants to make your wedding cake. Did you see that look? Okay?
Cameron, did y'all see the look that I gave her? That's what 150 napkins.
Just totally ignore
my cake.
She won't be having a sideways cake. He's gonna be leaning like this.
What I'm gonna do is I'm going to make a sheet cake.
Okay, listen to our argument.
I'm going to make a sheet cake, a very big sheet cake. Mm-hmm. I'll do two. Mm-hmm. And the bottom, it's a matter of just putting these cakes together. So one sheet cake, two sheet cakes. And then I'll just build them up. Then I'll make a third sheet cake, put it on top and ice it.
Mm-hmm. So you have
a decorator, little bake.
Let me check what Publix looking like. Then I'll get back with you. Okay. I want to weigh my
options. Mine is homemade and it's beautiful.
Thank you so much.
So yours will actually taste good.
Tastes very good.
Yes. You still want to go to Publix?
I'm just going to check and see what the price is.
Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to let them go to Publix. And did we get any information on the bouquet?
Hold up. I got to go back and tell y'all where the napkins came from.
Okay, and you're going to be looking. Did you ever get a response on the bouquet?
Not yet.
Not as of yet. Okay, and you were looking up what, Mary?
Flowers.
The flowers. So we're going to let them look up these, and then we're going to come back in just a moment.
Napkins from WeddingPaperDivas.com. And they were only, if you get one pack, which most people will get more than one, they're $34. But if you get three packs, they're only $20, and it's $50 in each pack. So I could get 150 napkins for $60. And that's monogram, any color I want, whatever monogram I want on them. The more you get, the less they cost.
Okay, so we're going to come back in just a moment. And we're back. Now, while we were on break, we went ahead for time's sake and actually looked up some of the other information. And we found that the tuxedo, we could get it for how much?
$200.
We found that the bouquet that we could get it for?
$50.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
$50.
You can make your own bouquets because the flowers were only two. Well, yeah, I know. That's what I was.
Gotcha.
I was promoting you, Miss Mary. Okay. We found the flowers for like $2.99 each, and so you could gather it and make it. The wedding cake at Publix, they start at $150.
So we're gonna do like the basic.
Beautiful cakes.
Okay.
On there,
so we got $150 for the wedding cake. Now, what else did we forget? The invitations. How much did we say for the invitations?
$240.
Yeah, $240 for the invitations.
And there's any design and any amount of words that you want because they're $201 each. And okay. We said doing what do we say?
Okay. We said 120.
Yes.
120. So what we need to do right now is we need to do a calculation, ladies, to see if we came in under budget. So let's go ahead with those numbers. Read those numbers out for us, please.
Okay. Dress, $182.39. Vineyard, $3.99. License, $35. DJ, $125. Shoes, $39.99. Tux, $200. Bouquet, $50. Invitation, $240. Cake, $150. Plates, $9 for $100. Okay, $9. Cups, $10. Plates, $23.36. Bubbles from Party City and the different little gadgets, gifts, $150. Napkins, $60. And that was it.
Guys, we just planned a wedding for $1,673.74. So technically, some of the things that we left off on the list, we could actually go back and get. Mm-hmm. Or we could use that money, because if we go on Groupons, and we didn't think about Groupons,
right,
we could actually pull up a hotel and all the things for the honeymoon and things of that nature and spend our money in that way.
You can actually take that $900 and go to Savannah for a honeymoon.
Yes, you can. And guys, I want to tell you that literally there are destination weddings out there that you can go to. And you can go to Florida and get married for $599.
Yes,
or
you can.
You know, the more you want on the beach, because if you just want the preacher on the beach, you can get it for like $500, right? But every time you add a flower or a chair or something like that, it's going to calculate. So you literally can go to these destinations there all over here. Just simply type in destination weddings. You can literally go and get them from anywhere from $500 all the way up to $5 million, you know?
Oh, yes.
But you can get married is what we want to show you on a very tight budget. Get some of the things that you want. You're going to have to make a sacrifice with some things, but we know that it is possible. Okay? And we know that God honors marriage. Yes, we know that it is a beautiful institution. And we know that it is something that we strive for, but we don't do enough of it in our community. Interestingly enough, other communities automatically get married, literally. And then they work together to build products. They work together to raise their children. We're doing it all by ourselves. Right? So if you want to get married, just do your research. Just do your research. It actually can happen. And let me just tell you, as we close out the show tonight, ladies, is that the most beautiful wedding that I've ever seen literally cost $25. I guess $35 for the wedding license, so about $60. A friend of mine who was actually here today called me up and she said, we want to get married and we want you to do the ceremony for us. Now, of course, I wasn't going to charge her anything. And she says, well, we'll just come over to your house and get married in the living room. I said, no. See, it's got to be something special. So what we did was we found a park, and right around sunset, as the sun was going down, we actually started the ceremony. So that literally the pictures are absolutely gorgeous. We took the pictures with a camera phone. They dressed in their ordinary clothing. And I tell you, when I walked away from that wedding, I felt as though that couple was married. Because it wasn't about the glitz. It wasn't about the glamour. It wasn't about the wedding cake or the colors. It wasn't about who was coming to the wedding and who was not coming to the wedding. In the end, it was about that couple. It was about their joining together. And they're walking together in holy matrimony. So they did it for $60. Ladies, I thank you for being here tonight. And I thank you for helping me to plan this wedding. Okay? And maybe we've helped somebody, you know, kind of ease them towards knowing that you can get married and you can do it on a budget.
On a budget.
Yes, indeed. So this has been The Morning After. And we're going to be back here next week. And why don't you join us?